Oh, I guess I'm supposed to talk now. Hello everyone and welcome back to the walkthrough. I'm just gonna show you the little ability rooms over here where you can get the powers as you please anytime you want to after getting up to 80 energy spheres, as you can see there. These rooms are all pretty much exactly the same in design. As you see, the powers are down there. You grab a power and you can test it out by attacking little robot guy there. He is, I think, invincible, actually, unless you, like, eat him or something like that. Yeah, but then just another one will just respawn like that. And it's all exactly like this in all the rooms. So, well, I don't really have to show all these. I will anyway, just for fun. So you got this room. Oh yeah, it's a room. It looks the exact same, except for the powers. Yeah, 5 per room, basically. Go in here. Oh, I guess it's not all the powers in the game. They can't have, like, Crash or Mike, I don't believe. Because they're like those one... Well, I guess they could have put them in there if they wanted to. Yeah, I don't see Crash or Mike, but anyway, that's really all there is to the game now. I'm going to quit the game and go back over to the, arena that was unlocked and start that sucker right now. Oh yeah, baby, let's get going. One player, of course, I'm going solo. And you start off in yet another ability room. This one really does have all the abilities in the game here. You've got Mike and Crash in the corners here, and yeah, but I think you know which power I'm going to choose. You can take whichever one you want to, but I'm gonna take that one. No, I don't need to charge it up at all. But dang it, I love this power and I intend on using it. Who's first? Who is my first victim? Basically, the arena is all the bosses in the game, all one after the other. There's limited recovery items, but this isn't too hard to do if you've got a power that you're comfortable using. And in this case, since you can choose any power that you want to, you shouldn't have much trouble doing this whatsoever. And Goriath here, not really much of a challenge, as you can see, even in Super Saiyan mode, as long as I have the spark power-up of death. And yeah, this is... Oh, no, 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 you are not going to... Aha! I know your attack pattern now, mister. You can't fool me. And... Oh, I was so close. Come on. Oh, I guess he fooled me for once. Do not lose your power, by the way. That would really, really suck. There we go. So I took, like, one hit throughout the entire boss fight that time. Much, much better than the other time I faced Goriath. That's because I had my good ol' spark. And now you end up in one of these rooms. This is a time challenge. You can, like, go for the high score and whatnot. These are your limited recovery items. 5 maximum tomatoes, as you can see over there. One in a crate, of course. And you can also choose to switch your power among the available powers. These are random when you enter the room. You can't know what's coming. And then you can see your boss in the upper right corner, so you can sort of like plan for it as you're going to the next room, basically. But I'm gonna keep my spark power throughout the entire thing and demolish everyone and everything in sight, and I'm gonna try to do it as fast as I possibly can just for the fun of it. And look at that, he's already in phase 2. It's almost kind of pathetic. Oh, Wispy Woods. You are, and forever will be, the easiest Kirby boss. Oh, you're not dead just yet. Now you are. So sad. So very sad. Metal General's next. I think I can do it without any recovery items at my current health. So shake it and prepare to die, Metal General. I actually defeated him the last time with the spark power-up with, like, no effort whatsoever. And look at that, phase 2 already. Aww, he's not vulnerable just yet, but he will be. Yeah, he's gonna try to do his missile. Ain't gonna happen with two charged sparks. No siree, mommy. I'm just like sitting in the corner and just spamming the freaking thing. Oh, I finally took a hit. That's okay, though. I'm not gonna take many more, I assure you. The spark is unbeatable. Well, okay, everything is beatable, but still. This is a spark we're talking about. It is incredible. Next up is like a mini boss all-stars mix of sorts. We've got Kibble Blade. Oh, I always shoot just a little bit too early, but that's okay. It's not like he's gonna do any damage to me anyway. Oh, look at that. He's already dead. Next up is Mondo. I shot it too early again! Luckily, it doesn't take too long to charge shots anyway. You're gonna charge towards me. There you go. I just need to jump over you a couple of times. And too late. And I might as well finish you off a little bit faster so I can get a good time. Keep that charging going! And oh, okay, you're vulnerable there when you start moving. I should always pay attention to when the boss starts moving. That's its vulnerable point, per se. And no, ain't gonna happen. Ain't going to happen, girlfriend. And another one bites the dust. One more, I think. It's WR. One of the most predictable bosses, despite it being pretty quick. It just pretty much shoots and moves in a straight line, so it's like, yeah, you're there, and you aren't really doing much of anything. See, it's like shooting down below, and it's like, yeah, you know what's gonna happen, no problem. He tries his best, though, you gotta give him that. And that is all because the timer stopped. What's next? Oh, the boss with the best name in the world! Yep! It's Mr. Duder! Oh! Who the heck came up with this name? It is hilarious. And I'm gonna attempt to destroy his skulls as, yeah, they're being shot like that, so he doesn't do any damage to me, but I can just deflect them with my spark shield anyway, so it's like, doesn't really matter. Now he's gonna try jumping up on top of me, and that failed miserably! And it failed again! And he's a really, really bad at aiming. Sorry, Mr. Duder. Your name may be awesome, but you're too easy to beat. Another mini-boss all-stars of sorts. This is classic Kirby bosses, actually. Well, okay, maybe not this one. The Gigant Edge is new to this game, but I just like seeing bonkers in there, as I was like, yeah, it's classic goodness. He's down! Next up to the plate is King Duder. Well, I guess you're new, too. Well, bonkers is the only one old here. Do your beam thingy. Yeah, it's too slow. Too easy to avoid. And you're done. If anyone still didn't think the spark is a broken power-up, well, keep watching. You haven't seen anything yet. I haven't actually defeated all the bosses in this game with the spark power-up to show you just how powerful this sucker is, have I? It'd be pretty funny if I took a hit from Bonkers of all things, considering that I beat him a lot of times before in other Kirby games, but alas, that just didn't happen. That's it, I guess. Landia, I think I'm gonna actually take a maximum tomato for this one. I'm not that good at Landia. And special Landia music to go along with it! Do your roar! Kirby, return to its Pokeball! Okay, maybe not. And I'm just gonna attempt to get past this first phase as fast as I possibly can, because I for some reason get backed up into a corner a lot on the first phase easily, but when it splits, I don't really have as much of a problem. For some reason, I'll show you what I mean here, and I was just gonna do a little formation of sorts, and see how predictable they are as they are at the moment here, and just move, yeah, like that. So now they're gonna do the little beam thing between them, and just gonna keep charging, keep shooting, and I did that way too early. That was my fault. never can shoot enemies when they're in the background, but you can shoot them as they cross the foreground. Almost down for the count, and they were going to play hot potato there, but it's too late. Victory charge. The Grand Doomer. Well, they did automatically start off with the Grand Doomer music here, as you can see. It's like, yeah, we're not messing around anymore. We're not going to try and trick you. You know you're going to face the Grand Doomer. So, let's just get it on. And, did I face the Grand Doomer with the Spark power-up? No, I don't think I did. I think I used the Wing power-up versus him. Still one of my favorite boss fights in this game. Even if the Spark makes this fight absolutely trivial. He's gonna try and charge. Boop! Ha ha! Gotcha, as you were coming in from the background. And what you gonna do? What you gonna do? Oh, you're gonna try shooting. That's not gonna do much because I got my Spark Shield of Death. I should add that there is not going to be any special ultra power area, super ability part to this boss fight. I think they do that so you can keep your power throughout the entire arena, because otherwise, you know, you would have to switch your power to one of the ultra powers, which would eventually, you know, run out. So I think they did that to keep it a little more fair. Anyway, next up, the most expressive boss in the game, in my opinion, Fatty Puffer. He's just so squishy and so expressive with his movements. He just inflates himself. Just look at that! He's just a very entertaining boss to watch and fight against. Whoa, nope, ain't gonna happen. Throwing fish isn't gonna do anything to me either as long as I have a shield. Inflating yourself up to a larger size may do it though. I think he didn't take damage. No, he didn't move. I mean, he didn't take damage as he went under me. I thought my spark shield would have nicked him a little bit. Gosh, I think you can duck under that and avoid that attack. It looks like there's enough room underneath that to avoid it. But otherwise, you can just do it the way that I did there. For this, you want to run underneath him. And I didn't really explain the bosses all that well in my initial part of the walkthrough. I was just mostly expressing my love for them more than anything. And so I think I did a bad job covering the bosses before, but at the same time, I guess you kind of learn by observation. Alright, it's the Sphere Doomer Bouquet. All the Sphere Doomers in the game at once. And I get to use the Spark! Oh my, this is not going to go well for them. Yep. Oh, he went in the background. That's just sad. One down. Next up is, oh, Sphere Doomer. So we're going to get a double dose of them. Two at once. Look at that, the spark just charges right through it. Ah, no. I mean, the spark just hits both of them with one shot. It's ridiculous in power. It just got that defense-penetrating awesomeness. That's just one of the reasons why spark is practically unbeatable. People typically think that spark is a very, like, it's not worth using if you want, if you want a challenge from the game, you shouldn't use it, some people think. And I definitely could agree with that. But since I'm making a walkthrough, you know, it's sort of best to show the best way to defeat things, you know, the easiest way to do it. And there we go, there's another one down. Is that it? Yep. What's next? The Lore and Megalore. Oh, people told me that you can charge your shot by holding the one button and then shooting out a star like that. I believe someone said that you could like get multiple projectiles, but I guess you can only get one by charging it up. But I think that's all you can charge up as well. I'm holding the two button, that's not doing anything. Anyway, I should stop wasting time. As I said, I wanted to get as good a time as I possibly can, so I'm gonna mash the button like crazy and try and dish out as much damage as humanly possible. Just gonna be switching between the ores. Very good. That's all about the timing there if you want to keep doing damage to the ship. And this time I'm not gonna get caught into that tornado that's shooting out from the sail. I was just a little bit careless the last time I faced the boss, but not this time. Phase 2, the 50% time. And shooting them in alternation. That's easy to dodge. I have no idea how I didn't dodge that the first time I played that, but whatever. Up, shield time. He's going to charge there. And he's going to start shooting from behind. So I got to dodge. No problem. Just stay at the right side of the screen. And he's going to go through the background so he can't hurt you. And now he's vulnerable again. How sad. He's going to do the flipsy flip flip flip. This move looks pretty cool, by the way, the ship, like, twists around in midair like that. I just like how acrobatic it looks. This is one heck of a ship, I have to say. And it's almost dead. Well, if you can kill a ship. Wow! Dang it! I did so well! So dang well! I suppose the ship does have a mind of its own, as explained before. And I think we're going to go over to the Magalore fights next. Yep. Is that phase 2 of Magalore? I think that's phase 2 of it. I'm going to grab the tomato, which for some reason I said was a vegetable earlier in the walkthrough. No, wait, that is phase 1 of Magalore. But anyway, tomatoes are definitely not vegetables. They are fruits. Just so I would clarify that. I'm pretty sure I've said that tomatoes are fruit in other walkthrough parts in the past, so I have no idea why I would say that they were vegetables. I don't know, I guess I was just concentrating too much on the game of all things, so those kind of things just happen sometimes. And look at that, phase one is already done. You see me face off against Magalore with the spark power-up, so this isn't really anything special. What black hole attack? Just keep running to one side or the other. Be pretty easy to avoid. Keep that spark charge up for when he pops into the foreground and becomes vulnerable again. There we go. He's gonna do spheres. That ain't gonna do anything. Kamehameha. That isn't gonna do anything either. I think you can also dodge that, just like Fatty Puffer's water attack, by ducking underneath it. I could be wrong though. I might be, because that attack is very similar to Marx's, as I've said before, which is an attack that you cannot dodge by ducking underneath it. And I accidentally took a hit there near the end, but that is okay. Making good time, I have to say. And next up is the final form. Well, I think this is the last, so I might as well grab a maximum tomato. It's not gonna hurt grabbing a maximum tomato. Yes, this is me shaking the controller as I'm waiting for the cutscene to end. Just to get a jump on the charging if I can, to get it as quickly as I possibly can. And final phase! This is going to be ridiculously easy. Watch this. I can dodge, well, not dodge the enemies, I can deflect the enemies just by using the spark. Oh, I didn't notice that was a missile. You can't deflect missiles with spark. Duck! Wah! You can also dodge that in the corners, obviously. I just do that in the middle because it's a lot more, I don't know, cinematic to, like, dodge in the tightest spot. I guess it's also pretty nice to be in a strategically placed spot. Like, if I were to do that in the corners, I would have to get back to the center, so I'd have more of a you know, more of leverage to get where I need to go to dodge things. It's always best to stay up in the center of the screen, unless otherwise for certain bosses. Right arm, I switch to the left arm. Yep, ain't going to happen, man. Ah, oh, I mistimed it. I was just a little bit early there. That's okay. And shooting, but that doesn't do anything to the spark shield. He's almost dead, but he's trying his best. Oh, shoot, I didn't see that coming. Wait, what? Man, I grabbed a lot of things at once there. Because if you notice that Kirby was like, he was sucking in longer than he should have been. That's it for the arena. And thus, another graphic death of Magalore has happened. Okay, that wasn't that graphic. 1359, not bad. I've gotten close to 13 minutes before on this. So, it's sort of disappointing, but alas, I mean, but still, I got through it. Anyway, that's really all I can do for this walkthrough. At least, oh yeah, you can now choose other characters after beating the arena once. Like, if you go back to the arena, you can now choose, once you click start, you can choose Kirby, Meta Knight, King DDD, or Waddle Dee. So Meta Knight is like having a constant sword, except it's a little enhanced. King DDD is like with the hammer, but a little enhanced. Waddle Dee, the spear, but a little enhanced. That's really about it, as I said. Now, here's some minor spoilers for you. Once you get through the extra mode, which I haven't done, as you'll see, even on my original save file here, I just haven't gotten around to doing it. I don't know why. The extra mode is a slightly harder version of the main game, as I explained before in the credits. But once you get through that, you'll unlock the true arena, which will be of all the special EX mode bosses. See, the extra mode's main difference, besides it being slightly harder with more enemies and larger enemies and stuff like that, is the fact that it's got different kinds of bosses. Like, you'll see Wispy Woods EX. Actually, I'll show you that right now, just for the heck of it. I'll go over to Cookie Country. Needless to say, I'm 100%ing this place as I go. So, wait, which one has... I want a spark power, like, really early. Where's the spark? No, this isn't the one with the spark that has one, like, really early in the stage. Was it three? Three? Sparky? Yes, you do. Alright, exit the stage. Now I've got myself a nice power. And over to Wispy Woods, stage 5. Needless to say, I already got this. Not taking any powers as I'm going over to it. Remember I said Wispy Woods will always be the easiest Kirby boss? Well, they enhanced Wispy Woods. But Wispy Woods is still easy. Well, in the true arena, it'll be covering... I mean, when I do the true arena later on, I will be covering all the EX mode bosses, so I don't really have to show the EX mode at all, because getting the 100% on it is done exactly the same as it ever was in getting the energy spheres. The only real difference is the bosses. As I said, there's slight design changes and stuff like that. By the way, don't suck in the purple apples. They will hurt you if you try sucking them in. Just saying. And you'll notice Wispy Woods EX has a few new attacks, but Wispy Woods still will always be Wispy Woods. Sadly. He tries his best, but alas, his best is not good enough. And one more shot should do it. Yep. Once again, no hits. See, I have half health down there, so that's another difference of the EX mode there. It doesn't matter if I'm not taking any hits. Well, that's all I'm going to be doing in this part. I hope you enjoy, and I'll see you in the next part when I do the true arena. When I'm going to be doing that, I don't know, because I have to unlock it myself. So what I'm probably going to be doing in the meantime is like doing some other walkthrough until I unlock the true arena. So I'll see you then.